Hello, world of YouTube. Given we are encroaching on the spooky season and we're gonna have even more colder days and atmospheric nights, I figured I'd take this month, as you may have noticed, to introduce some of that fall energy into the stuff that I've covered with the likes of Driftless Pony Club and Silver Sun Pickups, having some albums that I definitely throw on during this time of the year. But given we are at October's doorstep, I figured I would take an even harder pivot toward that sort of spooky atmosphere by talking about the second outing from an outfit that doubled down on some of the more spooky adjacent imagery that their name evokes and used some production on top of that to add to that atmosphere while coming to the table with bars aplenty. And it was a mixtape that back then I really enjoyed, but given it just recently got a re-release on streaming, I've reintroduced back into my rotation and figured I would reflect upon that release today. The release in question is the second mixtape from New York hip-hop outfit Flatbush Zombies, Better Off Dead.
So much grams, unzip the bag, dip in my hand, then I palm the trees, so when you throw shade.
Now, while I was covering some newer music in 2013, and I did have Better Off Dead in my rotation, by the time that it was out, my life was kind of in a whirlwind. I didn't even do a year-end smash like I normally do that year. My album of the year video was a vlog, if that gives you any perspective on what my channel was like back in 2013. But I loved Better Off Dead back then, and I'm amazed I never really talked about it, because I think that this particular project, while I do enjoy Drugs, and I can, you know, see them re-releasing Thug Waffle for maybe like the 15th anniversary or something, or celebrating Drugs in some degree, I'm not surprised that they gave Better Off Dead its time in the sun for 10 years, because I think that it's a fantastic proof of concept for what like a major label or a more polished sound could be from these guys, you know. I also think that it sets a mood and carries it throughout its runtime fantastically. I love the production as a whole. I think that it blends these darker ambient ideas with these elements of like theatrical organs and choirs and strings to set this stage of bleakness that the group uses to fuel their both drug parades and their attacks on racial discrimination. All the while, Eric, Zombie, and Meech really pen some great shit. I think that the subversion of the American dream on the opener American Pie unifies the three's verses about feeling marginalized in America fantastically, all while having the grand theatrics to act like a bombastic opener.
Those observations turning into frustration a la the Pink Floyd sample-driven Bliss, which has this big fuck you energy to its hook, and Meechie's verse in particular, while God Bless the Dead sort of looks at those lost in the sweeping of excess and sort of tangential fame throughout the likes of the loss of Pimp C and Captain Steez being paid tribute at the end of the track, while the overall sense of dread sort of permeates throughout the tune.
And while the more drug-laced, hook-driven stuff also illustrates their more massive appeal in some pockets, like on the classic Palm Trees and 222 with Bridget Perez, who delivers a really great melodic-driven hook, I also love Meech's hook on Palm Trees. I think that it fits that kind of laid-back, weed-adjacent, weed-soaked vibe. Which, I mean, a lot of their verses as a whole allude to their drug escapades. They just kind of tie it to darker tendencies throughout a lot of this that I think add a really good spin for these guys to channel, because they all have great pen game that leans into those ideas very well. Like the Death Twofer, which has a great dark tone with a hook of the zombies coming for you, which gets even darker in the second portion, where Meechie just goes off comparing himself to serial killers. Life from Hell also taps into that darkness really well, adding some more of that sort of rock-leaning ideas like what the live drums on American Pie kind of allude to with its energy.
I think this album's biggest strength is how well it sort of juggles these ideas of death and the chasing of fame in an early artist's career, while not being afraid to look at the potential dangers that are seen ahead of the attaining of fame. Because, yeah, death kind of permeates a lot of the track listing and some of the tracks I've alluded, and comes up in some moments, like on the sort of tongue-in-cheek play throughout the sample work of Nephilism. Zombie Juice goes off on Mindfuck, and again, has this sort of foreboding energy to his verse, while death sort of feels like a through line throughout some of it. He also pays tribute to Captain Steez on his verse there. And tracks like Thugnificence and G-Tears kind of look at life and death throughout the struggle as they've seen it. They also, again, don't lose sight of their bread and butter. They know that they're also rolling up amidst all of this drama, and I feel like they blend those ideas into this cocktail really well.
Like on the hazy guitar-driven regular and complex. Like on the hazy regular and complex GNB. Whose beat really cements the viewer in a more POV style that the guys write through. That slice of life also coming through on MRAZ, where that chemistry is just felt tenfold. All three dudes' POVs and their pen game is just strong. Those album-ass album cuts help kind of unify the record and keep it compelling throughout its runtime and keep that hour-long runtime super breezy.
While it does have moments that sort of deviate from that, like TP4, where Michi just kind of goes off on how well he fucks, sort of extending that into the close of The Results Are In, where he gets into drama with this girl that claims that he knocked her up, but he didn't do it. They kind of feel like they pull away from the message as a whole. While I like some of the solo-driven tracks, I would say that TP4 and I think that The Results Are In are probably the two weaker components of this project. You know, I also, while I kind of went off on the hook of Drug Parade, I do think the rest of that song is pretty strong. And while I like Club Soda and I think that Action Bronson is a solid feature, the track as a whole is a posse cut that feels like it should be punching a little bit harder, in my opinion.
And I know that that was a shared sentiment, at least to some degree. Anybody that spun it really seemed to enjoy it. It didn't get as much exposure, I feel like, as their studio work obviously has. But when it comes to, like, early on establishing yourself as genuinely talented artists, a project like Better Off Dead is a great example of that. And again, out of their two early mixtapes, it makes sense why this one would get its flowers on the 10-year anniversary, because it's definitely due. It's a project that if you know, but if you don't, you should. And I would highly recommend giving it a spin and adding it to your rotation, especially if you're wanting some dark, moody beats with something that may inspire you to spark up in its lyrics. It's a really strong project from these guys, and I think may could also be a gateway into their own particular blend of dark, gritty, weed-fueled rap. And those are kind of my thoughts on Better Off Dead 10 years later. I think that a lot of the production still holds up. I think that the guy's chemistry still feels palpable. And I think that their ideas of blending their own life with their drug escapades and their thoughts on some aspects of the world as it has been come together in a really good cocktail that I think is still pertinent in some degrees today.
It's also been 5 years since a new Flatbush Zombies project. I know Zombie and Meech are doing some solo shit right now, but I really am heavily anticipating their return, hopefully soon. And spinning this has done nothing but get me more antsy for more new Flatbush music.
Do you like this mixtape? Have you heard it? Have you not? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. If you did like this, give it a like. If you want to see more, consider subscribing. I drop 2 to 4 vids a week depending on what I've got going on. Thank you again so very much for watching. I've been Viral Rack. You guys are good days, lives, and situations. And I'll see you another day.